Hello and welcome to this presentation on using Ansys Workbench Mechanical. I'm going to briefly illustrate a couple of approaches to connecting the tip of a beam to the face of a solid. I have a simple bit of geometry here. You can see a solid body and then a line body. This line body has been given a cross section so that it will act as a reasonably strong piece of material. Here we see a mesh, and this shows what the cross-section was that was assigned to this particular beam. There's no shared node here where the end of the beam goes onto the face of the solid, and I have to manually set up a connection between the two. One of the approaches that I can make is to define a joint. Here it is, a fixed joint between a solid and a line body. You can see a reference coordinate system. Now it was positioned using a bit of geometry. It was positioned at the vertex of the end of this line body. It's not positioned at the centroid on this face. The default would be for it to go to the centroid of the face, but I changed it with geometry selection right here. Here's the fixed joint. My reference is the face of the solid. You can see it here. And my mobile side is the vertex on the end of this line body. So it's in here, and it's where the centroid of this reference coordinate system was positioned. Note that I set the behavior of the face of the solid to deformable. That's not the default, but I set it that way so that if I had thermal expansion in this body, I would not get extreme stresses because I was preventing the nodes within this pinball from thermally expanding. And I set a pinball region. I set it big enough that it will encompass some faces on the underlying solid. I do need to capture some solid element faces in order to properly transfer some of the load from the tip of this beam. If you need better detail than this, then you may want to imprint what the end of the beam looks like where it touches the face of the solid so that you can get the connection confined to just that imprint. This will give us, if we fix the back face here, turn off that show mesh, there's a fixed support here, and I have a force on the tip of the beam, and you can see that I get a deformation like this, and also some stress will be induced in the solid body because of that joint transferring the load back from the beam into the solid. An alternative approach, instead of using a fixed joint, is to use a contact. It's a bonded contact between a vertex at the end of the line body and the face on the solid, so it's about what you'd expect. I've also used a pinball. I set it to be the same size, so that once again I'll capture some element faces on the solid. I've chosen to make this multi-point constraint. I could go for program controlled, or I could play with other settings, but I've used multi-point constraint. And within that I get a variety of choices. I might try program controlled, but I've used distributed all directions. However, you may prefer projected uncoupled U to rote, meaning uncoupled displacement to rotation. You may find it confines the stress zone to a smaller region on the solid body. That gives me my connection between the two. I don't have to bother with making it a deformable behavior on a face. Again, a fixed support back here, a force on the tip of the beam. There's my mesh, shows you what the cross-section of the beam looks like. There's my deformation, and here's a stress. Now the stress pattern looks a bit different in this example because the contact is spreading its load out differently from the definition of a joint, but it does give us a proper deformation. And if I had a much finer mesh, we could expect stresses to have better similarity between the two models. So that's a quick once-over on ways to join the tip of a beam to the face of a solid. Thanks for joining me.